Afrogeez Television, how are you? Big Brother Mozanza is going to hit to come to an end, but more warnings are really coming in through from those people that are going to hit to socialize with Biggie, and a warning has been issued to Yolanda, Liyema, everyone who has been in that house by an ex-Big Brother titan, that is Yvonne, on how Big Brother really acts. Welcome to the Afrogeez Television. How are you guys? And where are you watching us from? I go by the names of Rock and David. Smash like button, comment and share. If at all you're watching us for the very first time, endeavor to subscribe to this channel so as not to miss out on stories that you do upload in here on a daily. Sometimes when you hear warnings from people that are really having huge experience than you, you have to clean your ears and obviously listen to them, because sometimes we are good enough. We are good enough because of the advice we get, and we always go to the ground when we don't listen to those people that are really talking to us. So today I'm bringing you this beautiful lady Yvonne, warning or issuing a warning to the ex Big Brother housemates, because she knows exactly how Big Brother behaves, and she has gone ahead to issue what we call a huge warning to all the people that have gone ahead to participate into Big Brother. And at a certain point, ex, I had him really hitting hard onto Big Brother, and looks like she really has a very personal vendetta with Biggie because of how they went ahead to be treated in the house and after the house, because a lot went on. You know, the content that Biggie broadcasts, you know, he doesn't really bring where a certain story comes in from. But when a story reaches the moment where Biggie thinks he's gonna really capture the audience, Biggie gives that a lot of attention, and when he wants you to be a villain, you'll be a villain. When he wants you to be a hero, you'll be a hero. And it's like they are having some setups they're already gonna hate to make. So allow me to leave you with this young lady revealing to us the games of Biggie and warning these ex Big Brother Mzanzi housemates on how to really take note every time they're really socializing with Biggie, because he's not an easy man. Over to this guy. Good morning, Ramadan Mubarak to the Muslims and to the Christians. We cover you all in the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Lego.
So you guys don't go to bed, you guys don't sleep. Wow, wake. I'm about to take off my makeup, shower, and sleep. You know, the thing is, I have church tomorrow, and God forgive me, but I'm not sure I can make it to church, because 2 days in a row I've been working till like yesterday after church. Guess what, guys? I still came back to Baco. I'm telling you, I went to bed like 4 a.m. This is not the lifestyle. This is not the life I want. I want a bigger life. I'm joking, please. I love the busy life. Crave cakes. Even if it is 5 a.m. in the morning, I'll do anything for you guys. I'm that serious. Oh, I just love you so much. Love you, love you, love you, love you. Today, Kosi was in the Big Brother house for such. I heard. Hope my girl represented me. Anyways, I trust her. I trust my girl. I wish I watched it. Oh. It's so sad how we can't watch Big Brother over here. I'm sure my girl represented me. I trust her. I trust my baby girl. Was popping. She was dancing. What do you mean? How can you be in a party and not dance? Are you a furniture? Someone like me, when I'm in a party, I don't stop dancing till they ring the bell. Yvonne, it's time to go home. You don't have a sister, Bakers. I actually do. I have help for now, but the way you guys are ordering cakes is giving, I might get a bakery, like a whole ass bakery soon. But guys, I want to get like another oven, because I have two ovens at the moment, but there's a particular oven that I want, because sometimes the orders are too much and I just want to bake all at once, because having to, you know, bake, take it out, you know, because baking takes like 30 to 40 minutes depending on the flavor, or yeah, depending on the flavor of the cake. So like 30 to 40 minutes. So imagine I have like 3 cakes to bake. Hey guys, I need a new oven now. God willing, you'll get that bakery. Amen, amen, hallelujah, somebody. Guys, every day people are ordering cakes. Like, I didn't even expect this, to be honest. So happy birthday in advance to all the April borns. Make sure you order your cakes from Crepe Cakes Nigeria. Crepe Cakes essay coming soon. I'll teach Sia how to bake so that he will represent me. He will represent me over there in SC. People can order crepe cakes from Sia Tanda. I'm sure he'll do a great job because he's actually a very good cook. He cooks very well. But baking is not his forte, but I'm sure if he's willing to learn, he'll get it right. I love you so much. I love to meet you. Oh, baby. Yamkela, I love to meet you too. You know, life, don't you just wish that sometimes you can just teleport yourself to like a country or to like a place? Just because sometimes it's very exhausting. In a love, please, I beg. My graduation is sometime in June and I would love a graduation cake. Okay, Ini. Where are you? Hope you're in Lagos. If you're in Lagos, remind me. I got you. Let me know what you like. Do you like red velvet? Do you like vanilla? Do you like chocolates? What's your poison? Everything sugar. I love you, Angelina. I love us too. Hey girl, love from Ghana. Hi Nana. Teleport yourself to SA. Like that would have been if that was possible. Every time I'll just be like, pew, pew. Up here in Santon, pew. Up here in Durban, because yo, I love it when you talk. If it... Guys, I'm sorry for keeping you up this late. I'll be posting a TikTok tomorrow. I hope I did well. But you guys know that I'm a dancer, so yeah. I did well, but I don't know if. And it's so great. So judge me when I put the post up tomorrow. Please remind me. Oh, you love essay. I'm not denying it. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. God bless you, Susu. My stylist, I love you. Guys, you need to see the looks that I did today. Oh, God. It's high time we take the styling thing seriously. You did well, baby. Don't worry. Your voice is sounding tired. I need to write. Yeah, I need to rest. It's 1. And you know the funny thing? Yesterday, I got home by like 1. I took a shower. I baked. I went to bed like, I think, 4 a.m. I was exhausted. And I had to wake up early today. I woke up around 8 a.m. today. Like, while I was in my makeup, I was dozing. My makeup artist was... She felt so bad for me. And it's like that. When I'm in Nigeria, there is no rest. Like, it's just... I don't like... Walking is so ghetto. Like, I just want to enjoy. Like, leave all this work. I don't like walking. But I like money, so I have to work because I need to maintain the lifestyle. I love you. Let me pronounce your name. Mushi Sine Mtobi. Okay, guys, I'm sorry. I love you all so much. I would have loved to clean my makeup on camera. I'm tired. How do you manage to stay flawless? Bro, I don't even know how I do it because the amount of hours I sleep. Sometimes I go to bed 5, I'm up by 7 a.m. because I need to pray. But I don't know, like, I think last week, for some reasons, I was going to bed early. Like, 11 p.m., I'm in bed. I love money. Money loves me. Money is in love with me. What? Money loves me. I don't even love money, but money loves me. That's my daily affirmation. You are gorgeous. Mwah, thank you. I love you. I love you. Sweet. Nomi tried to call everybody's name on this live. Guys, live updates. What's been going on? Nothing, no, nothing hectic, nothing much. Just work, just crave cakes. Okay, so what's even stalling me from launching Affluence Paradise is I've been waiting for these oils for the past 1 month, guys. I'm getting tired. Like, the fragrance oils I'm supposed to use to make the scented candles. Like, I've been waiting for it for like a while. Like, it's taking forever to get to Nigeria. It's crazy. I don't know. I just wish there was a way I could just make everything easy. Queen of money. You can say that again. Queen of money. Not anyhow money. Not anyhow money. Dollars. Dollars. Pounds. Okay, guys. Don't you guys come in on live with my crooked and my cracked voice. You guys gotta go to bed. Love you. Warm water for the voice. I will. I'll maybe tomorrow. I'm gonna be on a tea day. Hi guys, I can't wait for you guys to see the challenge. Hey. Like, I just saw it this night. I learned it in my next life. I think God should have made me South Africa, because the way I dance, you all dance is so easily. Like, I'm proud. I'm proud of myself. Hi, Wendy. How are you? Precious. You guys should go to bed. Go to bed. Go and sleep. What are you cooking this night? Around 2. Yeah, what are you cooking? Aibo, have you seen the time? It's two o'clock. What are you cooking? I'm not judging you, but you know I'm not eating all day. Okay, I'm lying. I had fish earlier, just fish. And that was after I was done with my shoots. Because I couldn't eat before shooting. What? For me, I'm sure I was Nigerian in my previous life. Igbo, to be exact. You need a name. I'll give you a name. What Igbo name do I know? Chinonso. I don't even know what it means. Just woke up now. My neighbor is playing some loud music. You know what you're gonna do? The day he's not playing music, just put a baby crying sound in loud, like put it, connect it to your speakers, keep it at the front of his apartment and play it in the highest volume, since he wouldn't let you sleep. How was the party? Hey God, I missed. Did you watch the party? Did you watch the Big Brother party? Did you watch the party? Oh, you went for an award. How was it? What was the award for? Like, what was it for? Oh, okay. People in the creative space.
Yeah. So okay. They never get acknowledged. It's only like sports people that get awards and stuff like that at an award show. So for the first time, they actually did something for acknowledge the legends and that type of stuff. But it was really dope.
You know, it's actually the reverse here, because people, I think entertainers get more, you know, awards. and more recognition over here in Nigeria. Sports, mm-mm. Soccer, rugby. I didn't even know we had a rugby team until you came to Nigeria, honestly. I swear, I didn't know we had a rugby team this side. So, we're not really big on sports, but we're big on, you know, entertainment space, acting, comedy, you know. That's more like our thingy this side. And are you coming for the AMVCAs? Because it's May. Are you coming?
If you want me to.
Aibo, which one is if I want you to? Please, though. The answer always be yes. I don't want to break your pockets. I don't want to break your pockets. I know I've been breaking your pocket of late. I'm not the devil. Let the account rest. The account is bleeding. Account is bleeding. Sorry. How was the party? Please give me gist. How was the party? Ay. This thing is not.
Remember, I gave you the gist before it came out that
How did you find out? How did you find out that they were all gonna be in the house? You just did calculated it. Big Brother is so messy. I just hope they didn't give him what he wanted, because Big Brother can be so messy. Imagine everybody got there and they were vibing together. I'm sure he would.
I was having a chat, I think, like with one of our colleagues. So she asked me if I was invited to go to
the party.
And I'm like, no. And then she's like, no, because we invited Blue. So I'm like, okay, that's good. Is she going to DJ?
But I think Biggie should have maybe let her also DJ.
I had a chat with Blue. So I'm like, hey, who else is going to go? She says she only knows Tamar. She doesn't know other people.
Aibo, so they, you now did the maths that, okay.
No, I called her.
Sorry, guys, we're just in.
I think it's a return by call. I'm like, you're not.
So it was intentional. No, it's good you let her know. It's actually good you let her know. It's good you let her know. You know what I like about her? She will always keep it cordial. One thing about her, she always keeps it professional. She's better than me. Better than me, because I just be like, oh, Big Brother, really? Really? But anyway, Sham.
I'm expecting my girls to be in the ring, man.
Ring for what? Is that what you people want? Girls are not fighting this 2024. Let's dead that narrative. Girls are not fighting. You know the funny thing? Those girls don't have issues. It's just the fans. Well, I don't know. Let me not speak for anybody. I really do not know. I don't know.
I think it's just the people.
I feel like the fans, but guess what? Some people fuel their fans to do certain things. That's why I told Von Star, people are not going to detect who I'm going to be friends with. That's not stuff people are going to do. I'm going to mess with whoever I want to mess with. Whether it sits well with you, I don't care what the person said. We have all said things. We have flaws. If my energy matches somebody's energy, my dear, call it a day, because I'm gonna be friends, so I'm gonna be cool with that person. Period.
I think
why would I mute the live? Hell no. What do you guys think of talking about that, guys? Yeah, actually cool. Like, that's what I said. Like, this fans just create wars. Like, I don't know.
They're really so chill.
My biggie is so spicy. Ibo, he's so spicy. He's a messy man. But tell him I said so. He's very messy. I mean, there is you. Who else is there? There is Meli. There is, who else? There is Ipileng. There is Tati. Come on. He could have just invited everybody. What you mean? He wanted drama. Forget, see. I know Big Brother in and out. They like rubbish. They like all these things. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. I know. How can you not invite Meli? Meli, that is the whole vibe. You know Meli can dance. So there is no way you want to plan a Saturday night party and not involve Meli. So maybe he wanted some certain narrative. I don't know. I don't know. I can't say anything, but...
I told you that they did invite him to the country. I think it's also... If they invited him, they also invited Melissa. You check.
Then invite who, Nelissa?
I'm suspecting...
He should have just extended the invite to all the Titans, if you ask me.
No,
actually, he should have... All the South African Titans should have been there. We don't have a reunion, so I don't care what you want to say, but I feel all the South African Titans should have been there. So you selecting certain people, I just feel like you just wanted to spice things up, my opinion. But I'm sure, I trust my girl to keep it professional, keep it cordial. I trust her. I trust her to keep it. Hey guys, Big is very spicy. If you're going to Big Brother, if you're going for any Big Brother show, just prepare your mind. I mean, nothing took me by surprise. I was just like, I hated the punishment, but nothing really took me by surprise because Big Brother is messy. Messy. Messy AF. He invited housemates from other seasons. Oh, really? Oh, that's nice. But was it fun? I'm sure it'll be fun. Who is that? It was the guest made it fun. It's usually fun. That's why I expected during our season, I expected Big Brother to bring back all the Titans for our final party. I guess he couldn't afford it. Because that would have been so cool. Hey, you guys, hey, what have been crazy. You had the most punishment. Tell me about it. The most punishment in the history of Big Brother. Like, I have never seen anybody serve punishment as much as I did. Giving stepchild. Giving, they just did not like me. Who is Tember? Let me not spoil somebody's name more. Tember. Ghost.
You watch his show.
Oh, that guy with the tattoo. Yeah. Hey, I like him. Oh, he was in the party. But I thought people would call him Ghost. Like, which one is Tember? Oh, that is his name. That's not true. I was very sad about your punishment. The thing about me. Those punishments, if you like, you should have told me to go and wash the roof. Wash the Big Brother roof. I'll wash it. I'll wash it gracefully. What about me? You will never see me that sad. I might be sad just a little bit, but you see that sadness that you feel like will weigh me down? It takes a lot. It will take a lot. Even that lot, I'll still do it gracefully. I know Ghost, but I don't know Tem. I didn't know it was the same person. I like him. I actually watched his show on Showmax. And I feel like he's a real nigger. I feel he's real. I like real. Guys, there are a lot of fake people in this life. So when I see real people, I appreciate them. And that's one thing I always pray for, that let me be able to detect who the real and the fake people are, because I can't deal with any of that fake stuff. Like, I keep it real. If you're a villain, if you're a bad person, accept it with your full chest. People that will love you, period. people that will love you will love you. Not when you're bad, you're not pretending to be good. Or you're good, you're pretending to be bad. Pick a struggle, darling. Pick a freaking struggle. What you talking about? When they started dragging you, you guys won't be there to defend. My dear, they should drag. What are they dragging me for? God bless. God bless you too, Lauren. You guys really think that dragging really affects? Well, someone like me, man. There's nothing that people can say in this life, but there's nothing anybody can say. I think I passed that stage like a long time ago. There's nothing anybody can say to me now at this point in my life that will make me feel bad. Libo was there too. Who is that? Libo, Juicy's friend. Okay, is it that guy from Eastern Cape? There's a thing they can't say to your face. Beautiful Yvonne, hi. This season, Big Brother made my fave not to go to the Saturday night party. Who is your fave? Libo is the closer guy. Of course, if Josie's friends with anybody that is closer, I know that one for sure. I know him. I know the guy. I know Libo. Once you guys just mentioned Josie's friend, I know. I know what you're talking about. Is Josie going to the finale? Are you going to the finale? Are you going for the... When is the finale?
Tomorrow.
Oh, you're going, yeah? What are you wearing?
All right. What haven't you heard from Yvonne? I think she's going to explain to you why she's warning these people that I'm going to hit, obviously, get out of the Big Brother. Muzanzi, welcome to the East Africa. This is not the East Africa. It's the Afrogeist Television. So continue to let me your thoughts about the entire or the entirety of what this girl is going to hit to say into the this long video. This is the Afrogeist Television, and we sign out for now. See you later tomorrow morning. I'm having Z, I'm having Papa Ghost, I'm having Jareed. Very many stories are really loading onto this channel. Me out for now.